क्विक वेयर बी स्टॉप्ड स्टूडेंट्स. स्टूडेंट्स विथ विच प्रोटोकॉल वी स्टॉप्ड. So you should know every protocol and their expansions, that is full form. So I think we explained about the network protocol definition. What is meant by protocol?
HTTP, versus HTTPS.
Yes, thank you, thank you. So we will continue from that. So quick revision, you see the what is meant by protocol means it is a set of rules that determine how data is transmitted between different devices in the same network. Okay, that is a network. So network means you already know that is a collection of computers. So how the data is transmitting from one computer to another computer, okay, that is determined by some set of rules. That rules is called protocol. Okay, these rules are only applicable for network. Okay, just so you know, that is that is why it called as network protocol. Okay, so actually the general term protocol means that is a set of rules. Network protocol means that network related rules. Okay, so then we discussed about HTTP and its a secure version HTTPS. Okay, it is used to access websites on the internet. That is the purpose of this protocol. Okay, so it is a request response protocol. I already told you everything about this HTTP and its a secure version. So secure version add some properties like encryption, authentication and integrity to the HTTP protocol. Okay, so it brings a security. For secure purpose, you need to go for HTTPS. Okay, so and you know all the difference between HTTP and HTTPS. Okay, so you have to consider everything. You write down all the points as a tabular column. Okay, don't write like this points. Okay, students, listen. If they ask a comparison question or a difference between question, you have to make a tabular column and write one in the left side and another type in the right side. Okay, everyone understood? That is a correct method for difference between questions. Then only they can easily understand. So, by which way both are different. Okay, students, clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay, okay, very good. Then next protocol you see, that is IP protocol. Okay, IP means Internet Protocol. Okay, for this we need some lot of explanations because I just given some related terms for exam oriented. Okay, but we should know some other things. So you clearly understand what I'm telling. Okay, so IP means, so I will say with some real time example. Okay, so for you, so you people are present in the class, so we will call you by your name, or you are also having a exam number, that is a register number for you in this school. Okay, so your name is a permanent one, so your exam number is changing depending upon the school. Everyone understood, students? So if you go anywhere in the any school means that exam number will change, that register number will change. Okay, so that is like so every device in the network contains two names. Okay, that names also called as address. Okay, so that only you can uniquely identify that particular device in the network. Okay, because the network means there is a collection of computers or network devices. So you will have some lot of computers, so you will confuse where we have to send the data. You should know exact name of the computer. Okay, so I will show you with the paint screen. Okay, I will draw some diagrams and you can clearly understand. Everyone, the screen is visible now?
Yes, sir.
Yes,
sir.
Okay, so you just to see, so these are some computers. This is a A, okay, and some other computer, that is B, and some more computers. There are a lot of computers in the network. Okay, I just to tell you with some example. Okay, so now we want to send data from A to E. Okay, this we can explain by some physical diagram. Okay, but logically how it will send the data means you need to connect that two computers physically or unguided media, by using unguided media. Okay, logically, so you need to give a connection between every computer so that it can transmit data. Okay, Everyone understood, students? This like you need some connection between every devices. This will form a network so that you can transmit data from A to E or A to D or B to E. Like this, you can send data from any computer to any other computer in a network. Okay, but actually, how it connecting, how it transmitting data means it need some names. Okay, I already explained you with two names for you people. Okay, you are having your name as well as your exam number. Okay, so exam number is a temporary, that is that will change depending upon the school. Okay, if you go to next school or any other school, you will get a different exam number, but your name is always permanent for you. Okay, so like this, every device having two address. One is MAC address. Okay, everyone note it down. MAC address, that is media access control. This is permanent one. We cannot change that MAC address for any device. Okay, another one address is IP address. This we can change. This is a temporary. We can change depending upon the network we are connecting. Okay, we can change anytime. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay, yes, so sir. This IP is a unique address in the network. Anyway, this is temporary, but we should give a unique name. Okay, so this number should not available by any other device in the network. Okay, so you can see that the example given in the that slide. Okay, so this is the example 192.0.2.126. okay, this is a one IP address. Okay, this is the number. This is IP version 4, means this is one kind of format. Okay, this is a 4 8-bit binary number or 4 decimal numbers. Okay, this is this one is 4 numbers, 1 2 3 4 numbers with the dot. Okay, 4 numbers separated by dot. Okay, decimal point. Everyone understood, students? This is the example for IP address. For example, if you want to give IP address for this device, this A, means we can give like this 192.0.2.126. Okay. So next, we can give like this. Okay, any number. Okay. But it have some rules. Okay, so you can give up to 255. Okay, 192.0.2.230. Like this, you can give any number, but the last digit is 255. That also you cannot use. That is for broadcast. So you can use up to 254. So when you going for network oriented job, means this will help you. Okay, students understood? So like this, we can give IP address to any system. This is a temporary. You can change it anytime. Okay. If you need this IP address for any other system, means you can simply delete this IP address and give the new number, and you can give that old number to any other system. Understood, students?
Yes, sir.
Okay. These are IP addresses. Yes, we can change any number, 192, 193. So you can just search it for IP address. If you want to know some other data, you can search it in the Google, or you can go through your book. Okay, you will get some idea. Okay, what is meant by IP address? What are the different kind of classes available? Okay, it contains 5 classes. Okay, because we are having 2 versions, IP version 4 and IP version 6. Why we need that 2 versions means, you clearly see, both are unique numbers only, but we using this IP version 4, you can see the difference between 2 questions, then you will understand. So how many numbers we can give it for IP, that is systems, means you can see by using IP version 4, we can produce 4.3 billion numbers, addresses. Understood, students? 4.3 billion. 4.3 billion numbers we can create by the help of IP version 4. Okay, that is a 2 power 32. That will give you to 4.3 billion. But IP version, IP version 4 is created during the year 1981. But see, IP version 6 created at the year 1998. Okay, during that time itself, this all the IP addresses are sold out. Okay, that is everyone used all the addresses. Okay, that much computers and network devices present in this world. Okay, because it is a unique address, so everyone using uniquely, so all the addresses are used. Okay, so you cannot use some other number, so that it already available in somewhere in the world. Understood? So they created, that is they created new version, so it is IP version 6. Here how many IP addresses we can create? No, so that is a 2 power 128, that is a billion. Okay, billion numbers, that is very large. It will take some time to sold out everything. Okay, understood? Very large, that is 7.9 into 10 power 28 addresses we can create with the IP version 6. Students, understood everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so just you know, IP means there is a unique address given for a computer or any network device in the network. Okay, we are having two versions, IP version 4, IP version 6. So IP version 4, I already told you, this is a 4-bit, 8-bit numbers. Okay, that is a binary or decimal. You can use any type. Okay. Then IP version 6 means that is 8 16-bit field. Okay, here you cannot use binary or decimal. Here you are using hexadecimal number. Okay, 8 hexadecimal numbers. Okay, so 8 hexadecimal numbers, you see, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, 8 hexadecimal numbers separated by colon. Okay, in IP version 4, we used a dot. Understood everyone? Decimal point. But here we are using colon. Understood? Students, this is one example. Like this, you can create any number of IP addresses. Okay? Students, understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay, wait one second. I will show you some IP addresses for my system. If possible means, I will show you. Everyone, the screen is visible, students?
Yes, sir.
What you are seeing now?
Yes, sir. Students, data, what you usage, are... properties.
Yes. Okay, you can see here in the mouse pointer I am showing now. You see IP version 6 address. This is the address for my system. Okay, this is the IP version 4. Okay, both addresses are using for my system. Okay, IP version 4 and IP version 6. Okay, for like this, every system having some IP address. Okay, whenever you are connecting to internet, no, it will use some name. Okay, that name is called IP address. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so yes. Like this, you can get your IP address also in the screen. Okay, everyone understood? Everyone noted that all the points related to IP version 4 and 6. And you should also know the difference between both IP version 4 and 6. Okay, so what are the difference mean? It deployed in 1981, it deployed 1998. Okay, so this is the 32-bit IP address. 32-bit means 4 into 8, 32. Okay, here 8 into 16 gives 128. Okay, 8 16-bit number, that is 128-bit IP address. Okay, how many IP address you can create by IP version 4 means? 2 power 32. 2 power 32 brings you 4.3 billion addresses. Okay, in using IP version 6, you can create 2 power 128. 2 power 128, you will get this number of addresses. 7.9 into 10 power 28. Okay, that is very large number. So here address must be reused and masked. Here every device can have a unique address. Okay, then this is the example for IP version 4. This is example for IP version 6. Okay, and DHCP or manual configuration enabled. Here it supports auto configuration. because this is difficult to give this much number for every computer present in the network, because I explained with the 5 computers in the network. Okay, just to imagine if any company having some 1000 computers, how to give number for every computer by manual. Okay, manually that will take very large amount of time. Okay, you cannot remember that much number also. So there is a property called DHCP that will give you automatic numbers. Okay, automatically it will take give the numbers like your register number. Okay, so everyone getting that next number now. Someone getting 126, 127 like this. It will align all the numbers to all the computers present in the network. Okay, understood, students? That is called auto configuration. Students, everyone understood?
Yes, sir.
Yes, yes. Okay, so that's all about IP version 4 and 6. Then we will go for TCP/IP protocol. Okay, so TCP/IP, this is a connection-oriented protocol. Okay, so it is a set of protocols that define how two or more computers can communicate with each other. Okay, that defines by which way, okay, that two are communicating. Okay, so which protocol it can use. So this is a mother of the protocol. Okay, it can bind every protocol within this and can send. Okay, connection oriented protocol, and it is responsible. So see, we are having two things here, TCP/IP. So TCP means transmission control protocol, IP means internet protocol. So here we are having two works, TCP doing one work, IP also doing another work. Okay, so TCP is responsible for verifying the correct delivery of data from client to server. Okay, it verifying, it will acknowledge the client system or server system by delivery. Okay, IP is responsible for moving packets from node to node. So because whenever you are connecting in the network, so in between source and destination there may be lot of computers. Okay, so this is the IP address. IP address know the exact destination, so it will send the data. Okay, so from which way we are sending, it will know how to transmit the data from source to destination. Everyone understood, students? TCP/IP?
Yes, sir.
How the data is passed between the computers. Okay, this is the TCP/IP, connection oriented protocol. Okay, transmission control protocol, internet protocol. Okay, so write down everything for TCP/IP. Okay, so here this is a combination of two protocols, TCP and IP. TCP is responsible for verifying the correct delivery, whether the exact data is received by the destination or not. Okay, it will check. And the IP is responsible for moving the packets. Okay, it will move the packets from one system to another system until the destination system received the data. Okay, students understood?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So in between this class, I want to tell you one thing. So kindly raise your hand. This BioCS students, raise your hands. Fast BioCS. What about Navantika, Sanjay Kumar, Santosh, everyone listening or not? Raise your hands, students. Okay, I think you saw in the WhatsApp group. So tomorrow you are having a unit test. Okay, so unit 3 fully. Okay, so for Max CS and Commerce students, there will be different subject. For Bio CS students, tomorrow will be computer subject. Okay, so kindly go through the entire chapters of that unit 3, all the chapters. And today study hour also there at 7 o'clock. Okay, and I hope everyone got the material. If no one having the material, or if there is any doubt, you can ask me. Okay, students understood? The portion is unit 3, that is database management, entire database management. Okay, all the 3 chapters of database management. Students, any doubts?
So 70 marks, sir.
Yes, for 70 marks, 3-hour examination. Okay.
Okay, sir.
So you have to study all the basic concepts of database. That is like what is meant by database, advantages, and the data model, and that related terms, RDBMS, and the terms like relation, tuple, attribute, degree, cardinality, and what is meant by key, and the different types of key. Okay. Then second chapter, SQL commands. You should know about the DDL command, DML, DCL, TCL, all the commands, and the data types of MySQL. Okay, character, varchar, integer, everything. Okay, then all the commands you should go through one by one. That is class wise. Okay, var class, having class, group by, order by, like this you have to go through one by one. Then you should know how to give the output for the queries and how to write the queries for the given question. You should go through everything. Okay, I already given a lot of materials. If you are having a book also, you can practice. Okay. Then the third chapter, that is MySQL interface with Python. That is a 7-step procedure theoretically, and programmatically, that is a 6-step program is there. Okay, I given everything. Just practice, 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 and kindly write what you know. Okay, don't get help from anyone. Don't depend on anyone. Okay, students, everyone understood about tomorrow's exam? Students?
Yes, sir.
Any doubts? BioCS students, I am asking you people, any doubts?
No, sir.
No, sir.
No, no. Okay, okay. Okay, thank you. So next protocol. So come to this protocol, students. The next protocol is file transfer protocol. Okay. File transfer protocol, FTP. Okay. So FTP expansion is file transfer protocol. So here the source and destination systems are called as FTP client and FTP server. Okay. So this is used for transferring the file over the internet. Okay, so we can exchange our files over the internet. That is, if you are sending from client to server, means that is called uploading. Okay, suppose you are getting file from server, means that is called downloading. Okay, understood, students? So this file transferring is called this file transfer protocol. Giving this property. Okay, so this FTP protocol is the responsible for exchanging the files over the internet. Understood, everyone? FTP protocol.
Yes,
uploading, downloading. Yes, just to understand. So here the source system and the destination system is called as FTP client and FTP server. We need some application. Okay, so kindly note it down, the application name. There is a lot of examples. I tell you one example, that is FileZilla. Okay, you can download this application and you can work with this. Otherwise, you can search it in a Google, how FTP working. Okay, FileZilla. This is the example for FTP application. Okay, it will use client and server application. Okay, so if you install this application in your system, that is, it will, you can make as a client. Like this, you can connect your computer to any other computer. There it will make a server. Okay, so that both the systems can exchange the files with the help of internet. Understood, everyone? So the uploading means that is a transferring file from your computer to server. Okay, that is called uploading. Uploading files. Transferring client to server. Client to server is called uploading. Server to client, okay, that is server to your system, is called as downloading. Okay, note it down. These are very, very important things. Everyone noted? Students, everyone noted?
Yes.
Yes. Okay. So that's all about today's class. So just I want to revise everything because we don't need to go very fast. Okay. So daily you have to remember these abbreviations. So what are the protocol? Just show this screen and recall that protocols. Okay. So now anyone can tell the answer for these protocols, students, one by one, just to raise your hand and tell the answer, okay? So what is the expansion for HTTP? Anyone? Students, am I audible?
So once again, sir.
What is the expansion of HTTP?
Hypertext Transfer Protocol.
Yes, very good. Okay, so the give chance to everyone. Okay, don't always tell by yourself. Then the next protocol, VoIP, VoIP. What is the expansion? This one, VoIP.
Voice over internet protocol.
Yes, very good. Voice over internet protocol. Okay, so just to recall. Okay, so just to try to tell from your mind. Don't depend on any material. Okay. So then, what is the expansion for TCP/IP, students? Any other? Anyone can try, students. TCP/IP.
Transmission control protocol.
Internet protocol. Okay. Very good. Yes, Prasanna Kumar, you can tell the expansion for this SMTP. Prasanna, any other?
Yes, sir.
Simple mail transfer protocol.
Yes, very good. Simple mail transfer protocol. Very good. Then what is expansion for FTP?
File transfer protocol.
Okay. Give chance to everyone, students. Don't use always. So next one, what is the expansion for GPRS? Students, what is the expansion for GPRS? Anyone?
General packet radio service.
Okay, very good. Kavishri, Charadeep. Okay. Then, what is the expansion of POP3? POP3. What about others, students? Kavish, Gautam, Hemvarshan, BioCS students.
Post office protocol,
third version.
Post office protocol.
Yes, you have to complete with that third version. Okay, very good. Then, Shiva Varshini, what is PPP? Shiva Varshini. Okay, she is not there. What about others? Shobhika, Suvita.
Point-to-point protocol.
Okay, Santosh. Okay, right. Then what is meant by HTTPS?
Hypertext Transfer Protocol Secure.
Yes, secure. Okay, it brings the security to the HTTP protocol. Very good. Then what is the full form of WLL?
Wireless local loop.
Then what is a telnet? Students, telnet is full form. Navantika, Neha, Prabha. Okay, always. Yes, Mugunt. Mugunt, I think something you're trying, but due to network issue, I didn't hear your voice. Any other? What is Telnet? Students, anyone? What is meant by Telnet?
Terminal network.
Yes, terminal network. Okay, very good. Then finally, we are having only one. That is what is the expansion for GSM? Any other? Any new students try to tell? Abarna, Akash, Kishore.
Global system for communication.
Global system for mobile communication. Okay, use that word mobile. Okay. Very good. So like this, you have to practice daily. Okay, then only you will remember, because you will get easily 2 marks with this type of question. Okay. And for remaining students, that is Max CS and commerce students, you are having a weekly test on Thursday anyway, so to tomorrow.